Hello guys, welcome back. So today we are going to see this type of functionality where you can see this frequently asked type of questions where we have a drop down like see. So as of now, if we load the page, it will show like this. So in for one question, I'm making it active. So if you see here, if you click on arrow button, you can see the answers. And you can also see the styling. So as soon as if I click on arrow button, the background color changes to white, and I'm showing this this beautiful font awesome. Okay, and I'm showing the answers also. Okay, and the background color is white. And if you click on, if you close that, it will close it down. Okay, so this type of functionality you can see like in on each and every websites. So this type of functionality we are going to build it today. Okay, so let's get started. So yeah, so this is our like, so this is our file. So we are going to build this, and if you see here, we have just imported the we have just HTML, and we have attached the font awesome link. Okay, and I've just given the title FAQ. Okay, and I've just attached the JavaScript file, and here we have attached the CSS file. Okay, nothing much, nothing in the body, and in the style I've just imported the font. I've just imported the font family. Okay, and in the JS part nothing is there. So let's start from the body. I will just make it little bit more, give more space to the code part. Okay, so let's get started from the body. So in the body we will like let's give the h1, because if you see we have the h1 here, we have the h1 frequently asked questions. So that's what we are going to give, frequently asked questions. Okay, so why it is not typing it? Frequently asked questions, I think some problem is in keyboard. Now after the h1, what I will give, so I will create a one div of class container. So let's give the FAQ container. Okay, so let's we have created a FAQ container. Let's create another div of having a class of, let's give a FAQ. Okay, and inside this div, what I want to give a h3 for the questions. If you see inside the div we have h3, that is the questions, and we will have p tag for the answers. Okay, so let's give any questions. Let's give the class for this h3. So let's give FAQ title. Okay, let's give something let's give something questions. Why shouldn't we trust atoms? Let's give anything. So yeah, so this is our questions, and let's give the p tag for the answers. So let's give the class for this p tag. So let's give the class name of FAQ text. Okay, let's give any answers. They make up everything. Okay, so you can give anything. So okay, now you can see things is coming in the on the UI. Now we need two buttons. If you see, we have two icons is there. One is arrow button and one is a cross button. Okay, so we will use font icon for that. Okay, so let's create a button. Let's give the class of FAQ toggle. Okay, and let's give the font icon. So let's give the icon, let's give the class of if a, so chevron. So this is for the arrow button, so we need chevron down. Okay, so this is first. Now we need one more, so let's give the if a times. Okay, so this is for cross. Now you can see it is coming arrow and the cross things. Okay, now what we will do, we need similarly this type we need five more questions. So for that, I will just copy that and paste it five times. Okay, let's paste it five times. Okay, so you can see same five question is there. You can use different question also. Let's for the first one, if you see here, if you load the page, so for the first one I am showing the answers. So in order to show the answers, for that I will add the class active here. So for the first one, by default I'm giving the class active. Otherwise I will add the active class if I click on this arrow button, and if I click on this cross button I will remove the active class. Okay, so just for the showing purpose, I'm initially adding this active class. Okay, so this is all we need. This is all we need in the HTML. So we have just we have the containers. Inside that containers we have the div, which is containing the questions, that is h3, and which is containing the answers, that is in the p tag. And we have two icons. Okay, so we are using the font awesome icon. Okay, so let's move to CSS. So we have just imported the font family. You can use any font whatever you want. So let's keep the box sizing border box. Okay, so let's apply some CSS for the body. So let's give font family. So I have imported the Muli font, so I will use that, otherwise sans serif. Okay, so and next in the body I will use the background color. So let's use the same background color what we are using in the existing project. So F0. Okay, so let's give some grayish type color. Now we have h1, that is frequently asked question, you can see that. So for that, let's give the margin to be 50 pixel 0, and let's give 30 pixel. Okay, so top and bottom 50 pixel and 0 right and 30 pixel is the left. Okay, and then let's give the text align to be center. So I want this frequently asked question to be in center. Okay, now we have this containers. See, we have this FAQ containers. Just copy this class. So we will apply the CSS for this container because everything is inside the container. So for this container, let's give the max width. Let's give the max width of 600 pixel. So, and let's give the margin. Let's give the margin to be 0 and auto, so that it is, so that it should come in the middle. Okay, so this is not working because we have given the max width, we have given the h1. So if you see, so this is coming in the middle. So in the smaller screen we were not able to see, but yeah, it is coming in the middle now. So we will make it even more in the middle part. Okay, let's apply the CSS for the FAQ, which we have for every div. For every div we have FAQ class. Okay, so let's give the background color to be transparent because we want the same color as we have in the background. So that's given the transparent. Let's give some border of 1 pixel. Let's give solid. Let's give the border to be 9 FA 4A8. Okay, so this is our border, almost dark grayish. Let's give some border radius of 10 pixel. Okay, so let's give some margin of 20 pixel top and bottom, left and right 0. Okay, and let's give some padding of 30 pixel. Okay, now it is looking better. Let's give the position to relative so that we can make the h1 and p and the icons to absolute, so that we can position it however we want. So let's give the overflow. We don't want to overflow from the container, so overflow hidden. And let's add some transition. We don't want to flicker this. If you see here, if I click on this arrow button, so it is coming in as some some transition mode. It is not flickering it. Okay, it is not flickering it. So it is coming as a some transition. Okay, so let's add for the transition to be 0.3 second in ease manner. Okay, so this is all we need in the FAQ. Okay, now if there is a FAQ and if there is a active class, okay, what we are doing, if there is active class means we are seeing the answers. Okay, so if I click on this arrow button, it is active and it's changing the color, and we are adding this font icon, and we are showing the answers also, and we are showing this cross button. So this is active, and now it becomes inactive. Okay, so for this active class we have to apply the CSS. What CSS we need? We need the background color and the icons and all those things. Okay, so first let's give the background color of white. Now if you see, so I have given the active class for the first div only, so that's why only the first div is showing as color white. Later we will make it active based on the click of arrow button using the JavaScript. Okay, so let's give some box shadow of 0 pixel, 3 pixel, 6 pixel offset, and let's give some RGBA color. Okay, so let's give some RGBA of 0, 0, 0, and let's give 0.1, and let's add 0, 3 pixel, 6 pixel, and let's give RGBA for this also. So 0, 0, 0. Okay, and let's give 0.1. okay, now it can see some shadow is coming under this div. Okay, some black shadowing shape. It's looking like it is a part of the page. Okay, now that's it for this active. Now let's add some more CSS for this active. We will use sudo selector, so of before and also after. So let's add a dot FAQ active. Let's add a sudo selector of after. So if we use sudo selector, we need to add the content and we need icons, correct? So you know how to add the font icons in the HTML. This is how we have added the font icons in the HTML, but here we will use the font icons using the CSS. So for that we will use the content, and we will give the slash that is required now to add the font icons, font awesome icons, and we will give the Unicode for that icons. So F075. If I just save it, you can see. So as of now it is not showing correctly. It should come, but yeah, faq.active, we have given the sudo selector before, and then we have the after selector. We have given the icons. Okay, we have given the content. Let's give font family. Let's give font family of, we have to add the font family also. Okay, then only it will show the icons. So let's give font is awesome 5 free. Okay, now it is coming as icon. Okay, see, now it is coming as an icon. So if you see, we have added for before and after. So this upper one is showing for before and this below one is showing for after. So we have added for both. Okay, and this is the unique code for that icon, and we have to specify which icon we are using. So we are using the font awesome icon. Okay, so let's give the color for this. Let's give H2ECC71, so greenish color. Okay, we will add one more icons later. Okay, so let's give the font size also for this icon. So we want to use 7rem. So it is like 7 times whatever we have in the parent HTML, the font size. Okay, so let's give the position to be absolute, because we have made this parent as a relative. If you see, we have made it as a relative, so we can use the position as an absolute so that we can position it however we want. And let's give some opacity, because now it's looking like very deep. So let's give opacity of 0.2. okay, so now it is like fading it. Let's give the position top 20 pixel, and let's give the left position to be 20 pixel, and let's give z index, let's give the z index to be 0. Okay, so yeah, so as of now it is, since I have given the both the position top and left, so it is showing like one, because here we have, but here we have two font icons, we are given the same position, that is why it is overlapping each other. So we will make it like somewhat on the top and left. So let's add a FAQ active, and let's give before, because we have to separate it out, because as of now we have given the same position for both the icons, correct? So let's give the before selector, and let's add the color for the second icon. Let's give the bluish color, so H3488db. okay, so let's give the blue colors, and let's give the position to be minus 10 pixel, because I want to be like it should come from out of the container, from the top as well as from the left part also. Okay, so minus 30 pixel, not 3 pixel, 30 pixel. Okay, I want to rotate this a little bit so that it should it looks better. So let's give some transformation. I want to rotate in y direction of 180 degree. Okay, so now it is coming, it is looking fine. Okay, so we have specified the position, and using the CSS we have added the font icons. Okay, now let's give some class for the title. We have the questions, we are given the class FAQ title for the questions. Let's give some margin to be 0, 35 pixel, 0 and 0. Okay, let's give some CSS for the answers, that is we have given the FAQ text. So let's give some display to be none, because initially we don't want to show the answers, that is why we have given the display none. And let's give the margin to be 30 pixel, 0 and 0. Okay, let's save that. We don't want to show it initially, so now it is not showing anything. Let's add a FAQ active. So if there is an active class, then we want to show the text answers. Okay, then we want to show the answers. So if there is an active class, then we want to show the answer. So now we will make it display block. So if you see, so So this is active. Here we are showing the answers. All these are not active, so that is why it is not visible. Okay. Let's move to apply the scissors for this buttons. We have icons. So we have given the class FAQ toggle. If you see, I have given the FAQ toggle for this button. So I'm applying the scissors for that. So let's give the background color to be transparent, because we want the same color whatever we have in the, okay, whatever we have in the background. Let's keep the border to be zero. Okay, and let's give some border radius of 50%. Let's keep the border to 50%. Okay, let's give some cursor pointer so that when we mouse over it, it will show as a pointer. Let's give the display flex so that we can position the cross button and the arrow button in the middle. So that's why I'm giving the position to be center, align item center, and justify content also center, so that it will make it exactly in the middle. Okay, let's give some font size of 16 pixel, and let's give some padding. So let's not give any padding, let's give the padding to be zero. Okay, so we want the position to be absolute because we want to position onto the right side. We have already made the parent element to be relative. Now we have made it to position absolute. Now we can give the position whatever we want. So let's give the position to be from top. We want to give 30 pixel from top, and from the right we want to give 30 pixel from the right also, and I want to give the height of 30 pixel also, and I want to give the width of 30 pixel. So let's save it. Now it is coming in the middle, coming in the right. Okay, now we have FAQ toggle, and just as of now, if I click over it, it will show the outline. Okay, so I just want to, whenever I focus over it, just want to remove the outline. So outline to be none, let's keep the outline to be zero, and let's add some CSS if we have toggle. And by default we want to hide the, this cross button. No, so if there is no active class, if we don't want to show the cross button, correct? So if there is no active class, we just want to show the arrow button, so that's why we are hiding it. So if there is a FAQ toggle, we want to hide the effect time. Effect time is the class name for the arrow one. Okay, not the arrow one, the cross one, if at times. Okay, so we don't want to show it initially, so that's why we have given the display none. Okay, now if there is an active class, so if there is a active, and we want to apply some CSS over the FAQ toggle and if at times. Okay, okay, so if there is an active class, we want to show, correct? So let's give the color to be white. So as you can see, if there is active class, we want to show the color and we want to show it. So display to be block, because we want to show the cross button. Okay, so if there is active class, we want to show the, but it is not coming. We have FAQ active, we have FAQ toggle, we have if at times. So we have given the display block, it should come. No, why it is showing the arrow button if there is active? Correct. So let's see. We have, if there is a, for the first day we have this active class, so it should show the if it ends at cross button, correct? So we have active class, but why it is not showing? Let's see. So we have FAQ active, and if we have FAQ toggle, okay, if we have FAQ toggle, because we have not given the, so if there is an active class, and for that we want to give some, apply the CSS for the arrow button for the chevron down. So what we want, if there is active class, we don't want to show this arrow button, correct? So we just want to display the none. So if there is active class, we don't want to show the arrow button. But why it is not working? We have active, we have FAQ toggle, we have FA times. So this should work, correct? Why it is not working? Let me check that. So we don't want to show the arrow button because we have given the color white. That is why it is not coming, is it? Okay. We have given the color white in white background. That is why it is not showing it. Okay. So that is why it is not showing it, because we have not added a background color also. Okay. So here we have added a background color of transparent. So it should show like, okay, let's apply the CSS for other things. So if there's active class, we don't want to show the cross button, correct? So if there's active class, we just want to show the cross button, not the arrow button. So that is why we have like hide it, the arrow button, if there is active class. Okay, so let's apply some more CSS. So if there is a active class, and let's give some toggle, let's give the background color here. Let's give the background color to be dark grayish 9FA48. Okay, now I should show in the middle. Now we can, if there is active class, we can give the color to be white. Okay, so if you see, we have active class, we are showing the answers, we are showing the icons, and we are showing the cross button. If there is no active class, we are not showing the answers, we are not showing the font or some icon, as well as we are hiding the cross button, we are just showing the arrow button. Okay, so this all we need in the CSS. So let's move to JavaScript. When we click on this arrow button, we will add the active class, and if I click on this cross button, we will remove the active class. Okay, so that's how we are going to handle it using the JavaScript. Okay, so let's go to JavaScript and add the toggles. Let's give the variable names toggles, because we want to document dot query selector, because we need query selector all. We need the FAQ toggle. Okay, we need FAQ toggle. So FAQ toggle is a button. This is like, we have this icon inside that, in the FAQ toggle. If you see, we have this both icons. Okay, now like, we want to iterate over these toggles. So let's give for each method, let's give the variable name toggle. So I am using the arrow function here. So let's apply the add event listeners. So why it is not giving the option? Okay, we are using the toggle. So add event listener. So what event we want? We want click. As soon as we click, we want to execute this function. We want to execute this function. So as soon as we click on the button, we want to execute this. What we want? We just want to we just want to check if there is an active class and we clicked over it, we want to remove the active class. And if there is an active class and if there is not active class, if there are no active class and we have clicked the icon, we have to add the active class. That's all we need. We just need to toggle the active class. Where we need to toggle? We need to toggle it the parent element. What is the parent element of this button? What is the parent element of this button? This div, correct? And we want to add the active class here. If you see, for the first one we have added this active class in the parent of this button. So the parent of this button is this div, not this div, not the container, this div. We want to add the active class here. Okay, so what we will do, toggle dot parent node, okay, dot class list. So parent dot toggle dot class list. So we are adding the, okay, so we are adding the class in the parent node. So how we can add? We can just toggle it. What is toggle? If something is there, it will remove it. If something is not there, it will add it. So if there is active class, it will remove it if I click over it. And if there is no active class and if I click it, it will add that active class. Okay, so it will just toggle it. Now if we just refresh the page, and if I click on this cross button, it will hide it. Now if I click on this arrow button, it will show the answers. Okay, so this is the beautiful like functionality which you can use in your websites. Okay, so this type of functionality you can see on almost in every website, this frequently asked questions, and you can use this functionality. Okay, so that's all we have for this frequently asked question project. So if you like this video, don't forget to like and subscribe, and please share this video. Thank you for watching.